गुड मॉर्निंग, माय नेम इज नरेंद्र सा, मैनेजिंग एडिटर एट मेट्रो रेल न्यूज. वी हैव विद अस टुडे मिसेस छवि भारद्वाज, 2008 बैच आईएएस ऑफिसर, करंटली सर्विंग एज मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर मध्य प्रदेश मेट्रो रेल कॉर्पोरेशन लिमिटेड इन अवर वन टू वन इंटरव्यू सेशन. मैनी थैंक्स फॉर शेयरिंग योर प्रीसियस टाइम विद अस.
आवर
फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू. You are famous as a corruption buster IAS officer. How does it feel? What pain and efforts you have been through to have this reputation, and how difficult it has been?
I believe you know, the reputation that an officer has in the public have been able to really set an example. So I basically, because of the kind of value system that I come with and the motivations that led me to join the civil services in the first place, I believe I've from time to time tried to do things that I felt were right. And some incidents get reported and then there's this whole reputation. But I believe there are lots of officers that I personally know who in their own way, sometimes not even being known in public perception, are trying or do try to set up a good example in public life, since we are all in public gaze and public life, we need to conduct ourselves in manner which is, you know, becoming of an officer. So that's what all of us, I in particular, have been trying to do.
You spent more than 2 years as a collector in a district which saw 50 officers in last 17 years. That shows your grit and commitment. What had been your strategy after being appointed as collector at Dindori, the district which an infamous repertoire of part of governance and work culture?
I have always been interested in tribal development, in rural development. Dindori is one of the most beautiful and also a backward tribal district of Madhya Pradesh. And it was, I consider myself very fortunate to have gotten the opportunity to serve as district collector of Dindori, because there's a lot of space to work there. There's a lot of latitude for any officer to do things that can make a positive impact on the lives of people. And a very important thing about Dindori is that the people there appreciate when any effort is made towards, you know, improving, bringing about some civic amenities in their lives. They've had a long period of relative deprivation because there's several villages with no electricity or road connectivity. And even the basic essentials of for living a decent quality of life were missing. And I believe I bonded really well with the people of Dindori. I always had this sense of great admiration for their culture, for the simplicity with which they lived, and for the remarkable, you know, symbiotic relationship that they have with the forest, with nature, which really enabled me to try to understand their requirements. And I believe my tenure in Dindori was the best period of my, you know, professional work life so far, those 2 years.
Do you think there has been any significant change in working of government department in last few years as far as project delayed and work culture is concerned? What would be you like to say about a required change in working scenario in the country? Do you feel any necessity towards it?
I completely agree that there has been a lot of a change in the manner government responds to its ecology now, to its environment now.
Metro project in Bhopal and Indore already has been delayed. The project cost of Bhopal and Metro has already raised by 50% of its actual cost. What as a new MD of MPMRCL would be your priority in this regard? And what are your plans for meeting the deadline?
I would not say that the project cost has increased by 50%. I completely agree that there has been a delay in the, you know, rolling out of various projects. And a part of it was, of course, spanned by the fact that there was this pandemic and you know, the organization did not have a full-time managing director. Mm-hmm. At this point of time, we are looking at 30.5 kilometers of Bhopal Metro and another 31 kilometers of Indore Metro. And of these, we have identified 7 kilometers as a priority track in Bhopal and 17 kilometers as a priority corridor in Indore. And the principal challenge that we have, you know, set for ourselves is that by the end of 2023, you know, which is exactly 2 years from now, we should be able to flag off, you know, the first set of trains on the 7 kilometer stretch in Bhopal and the 17 kilometer stretch in Indore. The good thing is that in the past 2 months, we've been able to award these projects. The civil projects have been awarded. The depot projects are in the process of being awarded. And we have also issued NITs for the important tenders like rolling stock and power and traction, which are very crucial to timely completion of the project. So I am very confident that by the end of 2023, that is in the next 2 years, we should be able to at least kick off the priority corridor of the two sanctioned projects.
So can we expect a smart transport system in few other cities of MP with yourself being the MD of the implementing agency for the same in the state? Is there any update on Greater Gwalior Metro which had been under discussion and long demanded?
So we are exploring several options at this point of time. To begin with, we have deployed a consultancy firm to do a comprehensive mobility plan for all the 5 major cities of the state, because of current data of the, you know, trip generation and the multimodal transportation options would exist would become very clear once we have a comprehensive mobility plan. But notwithstanding the result of the comprehensive mobility plan, we are aware that we almost have a 30 kilometer narrow gauge ROW available in Gwalior. And we are exploring the possibility of, you know, running an at grade metro light in Gwalior at the ROW, which is available to us. It is very rare that in the middle of a city one gets this kind of ROW, which is exclusive. We have studied the models of Nasik in particular in Madhya Pradesh, which had this ROW in the middle of the city and is now going for an at-grade metro system. Not a heavy metro system, but metro light. So we are exploring this possibility in Gwalior. We're also looking at the possibility of connecting a big city, a metropolitan city like Indore, with the satellite towns like, you know, Devas, Ujjain, Rau, Mau, Pithampur. These could also be connected. Then there was this whole idea of Bhopal and Indore, these two principal cities of our state. If we connect them through a high-speed corridor, it will spur urbanization along the way and will be a very big stimulus to urbanization, the whole concept and idea of urbanization in the state. It will give a very big boost to it. So there are several lines of thought that we are currently exploring, and we are in the process of obtaining data to substantiate the thoughts that we have. Once we have relevant data and statistics to prove that there is good viability for an RRTS or an MRTS or even an at-grade metro within the city of Gwalior, we should be able to pose a project to government.
Ma'am, you have worked as a commissioner, municipal corporation Bhopal. How do you see your tenure over there apart from bagging for Bhopal? The status of second cleanest city of India in Swachhta Sarvekshan in 2008. Do you feel satisfied with your work as commissioner over there?
Satisfaction is a very subjective thing, but I would say that I the most important thing that I learned in Bhopal is municipal finance and the dire need to do something very 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 different and drastic about it. I believe the cities in India are growth centers of the kind that would require a substantial investment in infrastructure and urban services in the years to come. And the bodies, given their nature, the fact that they are led by the political executive, sometimes lack the necessary wherewithal to raise taxes or to raise the sources by way of their own sources. While as Municipal Commissioner Bhopal, I tried to rationalize the budgetary planning in Bhopal Municipal Corporation. We tried to look for avenues which could strengthen the inherent, you know, resource-raising capacity of Bhopal. We tried to set a few PPP projects rolling. We also tried to improve the system for collection of property taxes, water tax. In fact, there was a very alarming scenario where we annually we would spend close to 90 crore rupees in supplying water to the city, and the revenue that we were raising was just about 20 crores. So there's a deficit that gets created in every amenity. You know, the costs that it takes for the municipal corporation to provide services is never kind of set off by the revenues that there is. So that has stoked a lot of interest in municipal finance. And if I ever get the opportunity to experiment with or deploy new instruments and tools, about which a lot of experience is already available in some other municipal corporations, I will consider myself very fortunate.
You have set several examples of good governance, like virtual coachings to tribunal children in Naxal affected Dindori district, and 4 o'clock review in Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and many more to name, right? What gives you the energy and inspirations to make such effort on continual basis?
See, I believe public service is a domain which you know, very few lucky people get to work on. I consider myself lucky and fortunate because I have the opportunity as a district collector. One has the opportunity to really make a difference and do what one wants. As we go up the ladder, the domain gets specified and you specialize and you know, pick up a few subjects and do things. So as a district collector, obviously the motivation to leave an impact, to make an impact in the lives of people who I was supposed to be serving, was the principal motivation. One doesn't get to be in the field and do something constructive for long in this service. There's a very limited window of 7 to 8 years. And it becomes important that one has a satisfaction that one did something which was impactful. And now as we grow in this service, I believe one becomes more, one has a more generic view of how systems can be improved and how we can, you know, establish our worth and our importance or relevance in an organization by bringing in certain measures or processes or ways of working that are beneficial or fruitful to the organization that we're working in.
It's been almost 30 years since you have been into administrative services, holding important portfolios. Is there any special incidence moment of success, failure, you would like to recognize and share with us regarding your professional journey so far?
I don't know what to say, but I remember going to a Bega village once. Now Begas are particularly vulnerable tribal groups. It's a community which is found in Dindori. They're very it's decreasing in terms of its population and the specific region that they inhabit. So on one of my tours to Dindori, to a Bega village in Dindori, I found that there was a meeting going on, and the natives, they were discussing the issues that they had with various government officials. The fact that, a lot of them did not get pension, or that there was a forest department guard who would not let them pick their produce from the forest or access the forest, or, sometimes PDS distribution was not proper. And I realized how important, government public service delivery was to the lives of these people, maybe to a self-sufficient city dweller who doesn't really depend too much on government for their day-to-day life. It might not have that relevance, but I realized the centrality of government services, public service delivery in the lives of these people, and the manner in which they narrated their issues to me, and the fact that they were angry, and I was the collector of that district where things were supposed to happen and were apparently not happening. It really shook me for a good deal of time. And I think that was a moment of realization for me, when I realized what responsibility, lies on my shoulders. And I believe it also motivated me to do a lot of touring, to interact with the citizens on a day-to-day basis, to understand from them what their issues are. Because a lot of times we stay in our ivory tower and we think that, taking meetings and thinking that things are fine, things should really be fine. But I believe a constant feedback system where you interact with the citizens, with those who are going to be affected by what you're doing, it provides you a real perspective, it gives you a reality check, and it helps you do a course correction from time to time. So I always remember that evening and that chapal that we had with the villagers to remind myself that should be the purpose of whatever we are doing.
Truly, truly encouraging. Would you like to share your views regarding your book, Like a Bird on the Wire? Can your readers and followers expect few more representation of author in you coming few years?
I don't know. It was a very... it took me 5 years to rewrite that book, and I wrote it during a large part of my paternity leave, and then while I was in Dindori. Thereafter, I haven't been able to write anything at all, and I hope I'm able to write something. I used to write a blog, which I discontinued, and I haven't been able to write anything thereafter, or even read that much, but... I hope with time I will be able to, make that space where I can start reading and writing again.
We shall like to know your views about Metro Rail News. Any message to our readers?
I believe it's a very good initiative that, that will enable any metro organization to understand what's happening, not just in the country, in different cities. What different models are being tried, what different innovative mechanisms are being put into effect by different metros in the country and also across the world. I believe peer learning is very crucial, and a lot of times when we go through the news articles in magazines like Metro Rail News, we get a lot of ideas about how we can you know, an idea that was done or tried by some other metro rail corporation that could probably be deployed by MP also for improving the feasibility of the projects. So I believe there's a lot of cross-peer learning and sharing and understanding that comes with having access to journals like Metro Rail News. And I like to keep myself abreast with whatever is happening in the country. Whatever models are being tried by different corporations, it keeps you aware of what's happening and what new could you do to your organization.
Thank you so much for your kind words, ma'am.
Thank you.